I'm Danny Mac. That's Joe Mama. Joe, if you were going to tell me, say 2 weeks ago, coming into the championships, we'd see a team come from a 50-0 deficit and win, and then just a bit ago, see a team come from down by 60 points to win, I would tell you you're crazy.
But that's what
just happened.
Oh, this is crazy.
All right, so we saw Naptown overcome Atlanta in the first round here in front of the hometown crowd last game on Friday night, and we just saw Denver triumphant over Texas, 210 to 199 to pick up the third place medal here at Champs. 44-point unofficial jam by Sandrine Ranjan. It was the perfect storm for Denver, and that breaks her other record from Westerns, where she got a 40-point jam over Sacred City. And again, a 60-point deficit to overcome that. That was derby, folks.
That's right, and it all sets up a great matchup, which we're about to enjoy this evening. Ole versus Gotham. The matchup we saw last year, a lot of history between these two clubs. They're getting after it tonight. One seeds from their respective regions.
It's interesting to note that several players have played Gotham before in the final, but not as Ole members. You're talking about D-Range, Psycho Babble, and Echo. So these teams have faced each other in numerous iterations before. So it's going to be super exciting. Ole's path to the final, they bested Minnesota, they bested Texas. Gotham's path to the final, they bested Naptown and then bested Denver.
Yeah, it's been unbelievable. Today especially, that first matchup, we talked a little bit about it earlier, but to keep that energy level up, we've seen these teams go full throttle, and the pace of these bouts hasn't been stop-start. Most of these have been pedal-to-the-metal derby. When you get those kind of points, those jammers are working hard out there.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure to watch. I've really enjoyed it. We're going to throw this right now to Bam Bam and Kool-Aid, and they're going to get the feed here. This is Danny Mac. I'm Joe Mama. Thanks for watching WFTDA.tv.
Hello and welcome to the final game of the 2012 WFTDA Championships. Thank you so much for being here with us. Again, my name is Bam Bam and I have Kool-Aid at my side.
Hello, hello, Derby World. Wow, Bam Bam. It all comes down to this. So much has been said, so much has been written about this game, about these two teams, Gotham, the continued dominance, Ole in the transfers, Ole been in the championships every single year that they've been in the WFTDA. Let's go ahead and go straight to the roster. Skating for the Ole Rollers, the Cosa Nostra Donnas, number 03, Adamatrix, number 13, Chica Chula, number 19, 72, Echo, number 2, Sassy, number 21, Psycho Babble, number 27, Deranged, number 2, X, Scara to Death, number 3, Lil Tonka. Number 52, Lindsay Loblow. Number 66, On the Sly. Number 7, Hockey Honey. Number 747, Joy Collision. Number 9, Tannibal Lecter. And number 911, Intended Anger.
And skating for Gotham in the black today will be 00, Anabolics. 16, Brazilian Nut. 1984, Cleared Away. 2, Donna Matrix. 201, Sweet Sherry Pie. 241, Fisticuffs. 31, Hella Skelter. 340, Bonnie Thunders. 404, Hyperlinks. 503 is Mick Swagger. 55, Susie Hot Rod. 68C, Sexiest Lady. 753, OMG WTF. And 929, Davey Blockett.
So much to talk about, Bam Bam. Don't forget, folks, you at home can help vote for the MVP of this tournament. There's one blocker MVP. There is one jammer MVP. Go to WFTDA.com/MVP, and you're going to be able to vote until halftime of this game. So
35 minutes or so, if that, again, depending on those official timeouts, which I don't think there's going to be any. I'm just going to put that out there. I'm sure it's going to be smooth sailing this whole game.
I will take that wager.
I'm sure you will.
And speaking of wagering, I'm sure no one is wagering, but you might be following the Bracket Bonanza, the WFTDA 2012 Bracket Bonanza. Only two perfect brackets left. Just two.
Are they opposing?
No. Both of them have picked Gotham to win the game. So if Gotham wins, we're going to have two perfect brackets. We'll have to have a tiebreaker. And if they don't, then we'll see what happens then. The points do double. Remember now, Bam Bam, the Bracket Bonanza is brought to you by the 2-in-1 Skate Shop. That's 2-in-1 Skate Shop. It's an interesting webpage, 2in1skateshop.com. It's shop with two P's.
Yep.
They are providing all of the excellent sponsor of the Bracket Bonanza. The winner of this weekend's championship bracket will win a Jammer Up board game, as well as a set of DVDs courtesy of 2-in-1 Skate Shop. The grand champion from all five of the WFTDA playoff tournaments will win a trip to the 2013 championships in Milwaukee next year, courtesy of Union Vacations. So It's a lot on the line here. We'll hopefully have the grand prize champion for you within a couple of days. It may take me some time to do the math.
After this weekend, I think you get at least a day, if not two. As you had mentioned, as we come into this, Ole has been, since 2009, in the final every time. They won champs for their first time in 2009. 2010, they came in and lost a single point.
Last minute jam by Rocky Mountain at the upper on the lakeshore to take that game. It was an amazing bout.
Now, when we look at the other side, we look at Gotham. They are the first team to actually win the Hydra Trophy in 2008. That's what they're going to be playing for tonight. And they have entered as the number one seed every year except for 2009 and 2006.
Mm-hmm. You know, interesting thing about Gotham, every year that they've been in the championships since 2007, they have lost the team that has gone on to win the Hydra, except the years that obviously that they won it.
Yes.
So that pattern will hold true today if they do lose to Ole, as Ole will obviously then have won the Hydra. Mm-hmm. Let's talk a little bit about the road that Gotham has taken to get here. Both of these teams, again, as you said, came in through as the number one seed from their respective regions. Gotham just laid waste to the East region. They defeated Carolina 437-8, went on to beat Charm City 283-86, and then in the final game at the Sugar Bush Showdown, defeated Philly 232-107. They've gone 12-0 this year with wins over such notables as Denver, Rose City, Windy City, Bay Area, Texas. Gotham is just, as we would expect, has been just dominant this year.
As they say, Gotham is Gotham. Now, when we look at the other side of the country, Ole, into their quarterfinal, they beat the fifth-seeded Rocky Mountain 157-92. They then went on to defeat Rose City 188-121. Their finals, they defeated Denver 168-161. So 7 points. Denver going on third place, becoming the third-place champion in this tournament against Texas, as you saw just a few moments ago.
Now, we've talked a lot about the respective playing styles of these two teams. Gotham, a fine-tuned machine. Someone said to me yesterday, and I thought this was the most appropriate description of them, every skater out there, every woman out there wearing the black and red, is a single cell in the body of the smartest roller girl on the planet. They know what they're doing. They're incredibly hard-hitting, but they have the fine details of strategy down to an absolute T, and they execute those perfectly. Ole is not that. We saw Ole yesterday have to do an official review after there was a jammer do-si-do in the box with a two-minute jam penalty against the Texas jammer, and they called an official review because essentially they didn't understand the rules about what was happening with the jammers. But Ole's strength is not in their knowledge of the rules. Their strength is in the absolute physical domination that their skaters are able to bring to the track. And this year, the team that lost last year to the same Gotham team has added so many players, Bam Bam.
Well, again, you look at now, we have one of, I think, the rivalries that people love to imagine. And seeing it live on WFTDA.TV, or if you're here in the arena, the moment has come. Gotham, the juggernaut that has been, has broken Ole's previous standing record. I believe they were 24 straight victories. Gotham over that by two or three, if I'm not mistaken. Ole now trying to be the team that then breaks that streak going forward. But again, Ole, a little bit of contention as they had some players that have come in later into the season to be on the team that we're seeing here today. So I think that we're going to get a crowd that really is for Gotham. You're going to get some that are really for Ole. But I think, honestly, everybody is just going to be excited about the hitting, as you mentioned, both of these teams, athleticism number one. As we come through this game, I think you're going to be looking for probably a game that's going to be every bit as fast as the game that we just saw.
I fully anticipate that we're going to see some of the, you know, you can call it by all its different names, the conga line, the sausage, you know, the passive offense. We call it a million things. We're going to see some of that. But you're right, Bam Bam. We will absolutely see some very fast skating out there as well, as both of these teams are able to quickly move up, move down, adjust the speed of their packs depending on the situation that's required. I'm so excited for this game, Bam Bam.
We are just taking a moment now. Miss Spider is introducing the team from Olympia, Washington, lovingly referred to as the Ole Rollers, the Cosa Nostra Donnas. Again, come into this as the West Seed number one.
You know, and don't forget, folks, all of the action is going to be available on WFTDA.tv. The archives should be up typically within a couple of days, and we have to give the folks from Blaze Media Productions time to get back home and actually get it all up. But if you watch some of the regional archives, it's absolutely amazing. We're also starting to see some of the 2011 games show up there as well. You've also got footage from the Star of Texas Bowl, from the East Coast Derby Extravaganza, as well as the August game. So please go to WFTDA.tv. We've just got some amazing looking footage there for you to peruse.
Agreed. You can go to those archives. Brought to you, again, by Blaze Streaming Media, a partner with the WFTDA. We want to thank them for all of the work that they have done, all of the travel and time that they have put in, the crew that is surprisingly very tireless. They come here, you know, they don't have the freshest faces, but their attitude is always great. They get the best footage on WFTDA.tv that they possibly can. And while we have a moment here that announcer Dwayne is introducing the team coming out to rock you like a hurricane, Gotham. I want to also mention that there's another member that some people are going to be familiar with that we want to make sure that we thank. And that would be, of course, our illustrious Double H, who has made it to all of the tournaments, put in tireless hours to get the production up to where it is and help all of the people bring Derby to the world. I don't think that we would be in the position we are without her effort. So we want to make sure that we thank her.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, Bam Bam, no surprise, a very, very full house here in the Georgia World Congress Center in downtown Atlanta, Georgia. They are decidedly pro-Gotham. I don't want to get into the whole politics of the Olympia situation. Much has been said about that already. But as you said, they did add some players very late in the season.
Some would say, yes.
And not a popular move on some fronts. And the crowd here gave them a very nice round of applause when they were brought out, but a huge round of applause for Gotham, clearly the crowd favorite here this evening.
Definitely you don't have any kind of regional favorite in this position, so I think that that's a good bellwether, so to speak, as to how people feel about the world of roller derby as it is. And we had talked earlier in the weekend about some players' attitudes towards the changes that are coming to the sport, so this is going to be one that we want to talk about, Kool-Aid.
And let's take just a brief moment while Dwayne is introing Gotham still. Let's intro our referees. The ref crew that was selected today is clearly represents just the absolute cream of the crop of all of the WFTDA refs. Our head ref for this evening is Professor Murder. The front pack ref, the inside pack ref will be Trippendale. The two jam referees will be Judge Knott and the Shoveler. And our outside pack refs are Code Adam, Werner Van Bomd, and Statsy.
Yeah, a crew well appreciated. All the officiating here has been top-notch, and that's what you expect at a tournament.
All of it?
That is what I've been told to say. No, you again have to realize that these are people who've been to region after region, and when you consider you have the regional tournaments 1, 2, 3, 4 weeks in a row, and you get just a few weeks off to then come to the championship level. And we're going to see, and we'll talk about a little bit later on, the changes that are going to be coming because we no longer are reliant on regions. We're looking at the division breakdown.
Yes, we are. Bam Bam, it is time, my friend. Taking the track now in the white and brown are the Ole Rollers. Coming up with them in the black is the Gotham Girls Roller Derby All-Stars. Jamming for the first time tonight for Ole. Who else? Adam Matrix.
Same could be said, who else but Bonnie Thunders on the line in black for Gotham.
Gotham starts off the jam in a knee. That will, as we all know, I'm sure, force a no-pack and immediately release the jammers.
Everybody, very tense. Crowd is dying down, waiting as the hand is up. In just a few seconds, we will be underway. Bonnie Thunders just right in front of Adam Matrix. Let the whistles go. Adam Matrix tries to move up to the middle. Bonnie Thunders tries to take that line as well. Pushes through a two wall, but does not get very far in. Backs herself out. Tries to go around following the hole that was opened up by Adam Matrix. Though Bonnie Thunders just, I believe, gets through the front of the pack. Gets knocked out. She is your lead jammer, Bonnie Thunders.
She is your lead jammer. Only doing a great job of recycling her joy collision. Does finally have to let her go. And going to the penalty box. Our first power jam of the game is a major track cut on Adam Matrix. Bonnie Thunders with a chance to really open up a hole here. She'll be jamming all by herself. Gotham, of course, immediately takes the passive offense. And around for a grand slam, Bonnie Thunders.
Adamatrix was just getting a little too excited, trying to get up into the pack, realizing Bonnie had already gone, and she pushed a little too hard, went out. So we have now Bonnie Thunders, again, into the pack, moving past the three wall until she trips. Wall moves up ahead of her in order to regroup, but they peel one off, so we have two. It spreads out, looks like they would block it. A little bit of a chase there. And she gets through. Joy Collision had to let her go.
Another grand slam as Bonnie Thunders comes back into turn one. Oli's got a three wall up front. Hockey Honey drops back to bridge. Bonnie Thunders now pushes way out front, and she's out. Another 5-point pass.
Adamatrix still sitting in the penalty box. Bonnie Thunders going to be back around. Adamatrix is now standing, but Bonnie's going to have plenty of time to get her way through if she can get past that wall, which has been great to reform. They close it up, they open it up again, so expanding very nicely, but it's those little holes that Bonnie is famous for getting through, especially now as Joy Collision peels off for a penalty going to the box.
She does, but the power jam is over as Adamatrix is out. There's another 5-point pass for Bonnie Thunders, makes this a 20-0 game. Adamatrix does get out of the pack, though. About 30 feet separate the jammers. Bonnie Thunders will look to get some points quickly and call it. Calls it off. I don't think she got any points on that last run. She did not, but still, with 28 minutes left in the first half, 20 for Gotham, none for Oli.
Almost went the full 2 minutes. We talked earlier about the jammers to watch, as was put in our program here, and pretty much everybody came in and has maintained around their level of expectation, with Bonnie Thunders actually exceeding that. She has an average before this at about 8 points per jam. 10 points per jam is where she has been in this tournament right now. Certainly double that, because we've only had one underway. We've got Susie Hot Rod, 55 for Gotham, hopping and skipping, trying to move her way up through the pack. She has got number 66. That is On the Sly jamming as well.
Both jammers worked their way towards the front of the pack. On the Sly is forced out of bounds, has to come back behind her. Susie Hot Rod is there as well. Quick moving pass comes around turn four. On the Sly takes a knee. She's knocked down. Up front is Susie Hot Rod. She's out for lead jammer.
On the Sly, though, is almost through the pack, but she has got one to get past. Almost able to do it. Adam Box pulls her out. She's got to recycle herself and get around. She has indeed. She's got half a track behind. Susie Hot Rod now coming into the pack, looking to see if she's going to get any opportunity. She's got to try to force it in. She gets up into about the middle of the pack, realizes jammer for Oli is coming through, calls it, gets 3 points. 3-0 gain on that, so Gotham now 23, Oli at zero.
On the Sly, almost able to sneak through there right at the end and get some points, but the fourth whistle blew before she was able to get it done. Coming back to the jammer line is Bonnie Thunders. Coming back to the jammer line for Oli is Adamatrix. 23-0, 26 and a half minutes left in the first half. One blocker for Gotham sitting in the penalty box, one blocker for Oli standing. So we'll be 4-on-3 here shortly. There's the whistle, Bam Bam.
Adamatrix just trying to move inside. She holds up into the middle as Bonnie Thunders pushes around that outside edge, cuts up inside, becomes your lead jammer in about 5 seconds flat. Adamatrix trying to follow that hole, but it closes up very quickly because OMG WTF is not going to let her do it.
And a major forearm being caught on Adamatrix. Another power jam for Bonnie Thunders.
She's got an interesting smile on her face. Adamatrix definitely had too much momentum on that arm as it extended away from the body. OMG also tumbles backwards, making it that much easier for the referee to see.
Meanwhile, Bonnie Thunders has gotten through for a 5-point pass. Joy Collision was able to take her down, but I believe out of play was the call on that hit. This makes now only two blockers for Oli out there, as here comes Bonnie Thunders on her second scoring run.
We're only on our third jam, and Adamatrix and Joy Collision twice in the box already, as we have Bonnie Thunders getting a nice last bit of a move around the edge of the last defender, picking up 5 points. She's got her full contingent out there as four in black are waiting to assist. Bonnie Thunders with the pack one more time.
Pack stuck in the straightaway between turns two and three. Again, Gotham blockers not moving as we expect. I'm seeing some minor back blocks being called on Bonnie Thunders. Nothing major as she does a nice juke move past range. That's another grand slam.
The passive offense in effect, but they're not lining up along that outside wall. They formed a ridge, 1, 2, 3, 4 wide. Wall of death, so to speak. Hold that position. We're holding it again as the jam concludes there. We have Oli and a replay right now. You can see the hit in mere moments. That is it. Lifting her arm from the side of her body, pretty much extending it all the way out.
That was not a chicken wing. That was the entire chicken as she forced OMG to the ground. Good call by the refs. So this brings up now, I believe Claire DeWay comes to the jammer line for Gotham. 38-0 with under 25 minutes left, and Adamatrix still sitting in the penalty box.
Adamatrix just standing right now. She has a few seconds left. She has got number 27 to range coming in for Oli to assist in a moment. But either way, cleared away, is your lead jammer.
So Animatrix now back out. This is her initial pass here. Comes cleared away on a scoring run. Comes in hot. Works her way outside the inside. Two Oli blockers in front of her. Gets past one. Gets past the other. Stays in bounds. Deranged chases. Cleared away. Gets grounded. That's a five-point grand slam. Bam, bam.
Deranged was inside the zone of engagement, so she did not get outside of 20 feet, but cleared away. A little credit to her. She's been able to stay on her feet as she's doing right now, coming up into the pack, getting behind Joy Collision, not able to get around quite yet. The black four wall, as we see, not all the way out of the way, but just holding position.
As Adamatrix is sitting in the penalty box again, Bam Bam, I did not see the call, I apologize.
Not sure, maybe she left early. We're gonna get an update for you as soon as we can, but in the meantime, 5 points for cleared away. One more time, as you can see on your screen, one, two, three, four wide, just holding their position. Gonna make cleared away work for it. And pretty much any jammer Gotham puts out is able to make their own path. There, she's not able to. She's got to pull herself all the way back to range, backing well up, being joined by Joy Collision. Now two in the way.
Joy Collision did a great job of moving back to keep Deranged in play as Deranged was coming back to force Claire the way to come even further back to avoid the track cut.
And I want to say that was very nicely done. Deranged holding a position within 20 feet so that she could be joined by Joy Collision.
And there we see Claire the way doing a great job. She stays in bounds. So we're coming back to it now, 22, almost 23 minutes left in the first half, 51 for Gotham, no points for Olympia. Adamatrix still sitting in the penalty box. She's been in there for, this will be her fourth jam, three trips to the box for Adamatrix, and jamming for Gotham is Brazilian Nut.
As you might have been able to see on your screen, interesting move, Susie Hot Rod way at the front of the pack, gets called for an intentional fourth, goes all the way around, not at the back. Not sure what the benefit of that would be, but either way, she is in the box right now.
Adamatrix is out. Power jam is over. Brazilian Nut still working on her initial pass. She's up front with Deranged. Excuse me, Psycho Babble. And Adamatrix gets through. Adamatrix first lead jammer for the game. So Brazilian Nut, who had a really rough game yesterday, trying to make her initial pass still through this pack. And here's Adamatrix now on a scoring run. She's got some points. She's around. 5 points for Olympia, and they get on the board in style with a natural grand slam. And going to the penalty box now is Brazilian Nut, Bam Bam.
That is a minor back block. That is her fourth. That is going to send her out. So this is a power jam for Oli. Picks up only 4 points on that. I'm not sure. Looks like she had engaged the pack after the jammer was already set up for Gotham. Not sure why she only got four, but she does get five on that pass. So Oli is starting to make a run. Gotham at 51, Oli at 14. She has got 50 seconds left and is already back into the pack.
Only two blockers is sitting for Gotham as Adamatrix is able to easily get around them. Penalty box does now clear for Gotham, so 4-on-3 pack advantage for Gotham. Adamatrix comes in on another scoring run right into turn one, trying to get around Susie Hot Rod. Hot Rod doing a great job of holding her. Adamatrix, though, is able to juke to the inside. That's another grand slam for Adamatrix. 24 points now for Oli.
Sweet Cherry Pie going to the penalty box, so it thins back out, and it is even. We had Hockey Honey in the box. She is now coming back into the pack, right, though, as the pivot comes out. So Psycho Babble is going to be sitting in the box. We've got nice bit of an opening almost provided by Susie Hot Rod. She's able to then switch to get the close on Adamatrix. She comes through, calls it, though she has picked up 5 points in that pass. So Gotham is going to sit at 51 as Brazilian Nut is standing in the box. She'll be able to come in just a few seconds. But Oli comes roaring back with 29 points. Kool-Aid.
And Adamatrix so good. Shows to the outside. And really nice hit there. I would question if that maybe was the penalty we didn't see. She did initiate contact with both of her skates off the ground. So anyway, be that as it may, 51-29. Brazilian Nut, who again had a rough go of it yesterday, is the jammer standing in the penalty box for Gotham.
Coach is out there having a quick, Coach Roli is out there having a discussion with our head rep, Professor Murder. But he's got to be a little bit of a smile. You don't see that very often because we have Lee Jam going to number 66 on the slide for Oli.
Brazilian Nut is out, made her initial pass, so on the slide, likely only one opportunity to score points here. Two blockers on the track for Gotham. Pack Sexy Slady passed Bonnie Fisticuffs, and that's 4 points. On the slide is not calling it off. Now she does. And Gotham was able to score 1 point on that kind
two,
of a late,
I believe.
2 points.
I think I see a pinky.
A late call off there by On the Slide. But you won't be late if you buy some Rydell skates. They'll get you there on time. Rydell is the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance, RydellSkates.com.
And as you can see on your screen, some nice replay. We've got On the Slide coming around. She is looking for an opportunity. Pixie Slady not only goes for the block, then shoves the pivot over just to see if she can close the gap. Not quite able to do it. As we get our whistles back underway, Bonnie Fenders, number 340 for Gotham, pushing in the outside. Hockey Honey turned around saying, nah, I don't, and draws the foul because of it.
Bonnie Thunders gets out for Lee Jam, and out but not lead is deranged.
Hockey Honey had to take a long way around. We've got Nick Swager going to be joining her in the box as well for Gotham, so that's going to make it a little bit more even. But we have two in the box center right now, one standing up for Gotham as Bonnie Thunders comes around. We'll see if she's able to pick up how many points. Three for Gotham. So only 33, Gotham 56, 18:40 left to play.
Animatrix comes back to the jammer line. The fifth time Animatrix has jammed for Oli. Her first three trips out there, she went to the penalty box three times. On her fourth trip out, which we actually started that jam in the penalty box, she was able to score 29 points. That is Susie Hot Rod on the jammer line for Gotham.
Yes.
There's the whistles.
Animatrix jamming for Oli, moves from inside to outside, pushes out around, she becomes your lead jammer. Back again, a little thin, it's making it easy for these jammers to get through that much faster. Animatrix coming back around, she's about halfway, a quarter of the way to the pack at this point. Susie Hot Rod gets spun out, slows her down, doesn't even have time to get into a defensive position, has to keep moving forward on offense.
So here's Animatrix now looking for the jammer lap point. Nice move, she gets past fisticuffs, and that's a grand slam for Adamatrix.
Almost gets an incidental elbow to the face, but is able to duck under that. We've got Susie Hot Rod now waiting, but she gets...
She's getting no luck with Little Tonka and Joy collision there, yes, towards the front. Now Tannable Lecter with a nice hit, and a penalty called on Tannable, I believe, direction of gameplay. Hot Rod almost able to get out, but Little Tonka holds her. So again, still the initial pass for Hot Rod as Adamatrix now in a scoring run.
We have got Hockey Honey back in. We've got Mick Swager back in. One team piece being represented there. So the pack is a little bit thicker, but Adamatrix decides to call it, only picking up 1 point on that pass, 0 point for Gotham. So we have got 56 Gotham, and an update in a moment as we see our replay coming right there. Nice hit, Sexy Slady. That was the one that sent her to the penalty box, I believe.
No call on Adamatrix on a track cut as Sexy Slady had gone out of bounds with the continuance of the hit. So 56-39, Gotham in black over Oli in white. Just under 17 minutes left in the first half. Bonnie Thunders comes to the jammer line for Gotham. And that is on the slide, comes back to the jammer line for Olympia.
Waiting patiently.
Jam has begun. Both teams have one blocker in the penalty box, so neither team really gaining or losing advantage here.
No, again, you have to accept, though, that this is the possibility for both of these teams to rest. And I don't think that that's the worst decision when you only got about 14 minutes in so far. You've got less than 20 points between the two. Fans, of course, not the biggest fan of the strategy, but still, both sitting in the box, though, both standing at the same time.
Psychobabble doing her her usual dancing when no one's skating, but if she didn't like this, she could skate forward, but choosing not to. So far, 7 minutes in the box for Olympia, 8 for Gotham as a team. Everyone's out. Fans start chanting, let's skate forward. Looks like Oli's going to release the pack here. Three take a knee, one skates forward. No pack is called, and we're off.
I think that was a smart thing to do. Sometimes you just have to draw it out. Bonnie Thunders getting nice bounce again and again and again. Goes down, blocker for Oli, then follows. So Bonnie Thunders pop back up, gets out around, and she is your lead jammer.
Oh, huge hit by Slady on the slide, forces her all the way back. Up now quickly and around. Jukes past Donna Matrix, tries to get past Hyperlink. She does. On the slides out.
Gray's out there. Look, that is Psychobabble, number 21 for Oli. Doing another great job defending on Bonnie Thunders. Now she's got some assistance. Not long enough, though, that she's going to be able to
cut. Cut track major on Bonnie Thunders just as she was calling it off.
Makes the attempt,
but did not get it in time. This is the power jam now for On the Sly, who is not the lead jammer. 5-point grand slam, though, for On the Sly.
I would not be out of statement if I said that this is the first time Bonnie Thunders has gone to the penalty box as jammer all weekend. So a big change of pace right now. Gotham only leading by 12 points currently. We're going to update 3 more points right there. We're going to go up by 3 as well. So still a 12-point game. Halfway through the first half, we're going to see right now on our screen Bonnie Thunders trying to move that inside line. Nice hit comes across. Looks like it did. Her left skate seems to have gone across to that inside lane, and the shoveler, look of surprise on Bonnie's face, says it all.
To what now?
Me? I'm sure you must be mistaken, shoveler.
So 59-47, 14 minutes left in the game, deranged on the jammer line for Olympia. Three blockers each for the teams. Deranged up around stays and mounts. She's lead jammer.
Interesting bit of a hop. It looks like Fisticuffs was able to stand, but they tried to get some kind of cut, but not able to do it to get the call on her. Grace has to go back out. Now she's got to recycle herself, pull her into the middle of the pack, looking again to pass, making her do all the work as all these defenders staying well behind.
Solid defense here by Gotham. There's a minor track cut on deranged. And the Bullocks up front holding her. Gets around Mick Swaggers, does deranged. There's 4 points. Again, she'll miss the point on Fisticuffs with the minor track cut.
But I think that was a smart move to do. You don't want to keep going back. She got pushed back 2 times already. She can take that minor because she has Bonnie Thunders in the box. You have to take advantage of that right now. So that's going to close it up to an 8-point game. Gotham 59, Ole 51. Bonnie Thunders standing in the penalty box. Number two right next to her, Donna Matrix, standing. And then with those two out, I think we will, for the first time in a while, have clear penalty boxes. So penalty's been a big factor in the game so far. A few seconds, we'll get back underway. Adam Matrix, 0-3 in the white for Ole. First to jam, she's the only one out there.
Takes it, forced down is Bonnie Thunders, is Adam Matrix. Bonnie Thunders is now out, gets through. Bonnie Thunders is eligible for lead, and she is lead jammer, Bonnie Thunders.
Looks like Tanabel Lecter was trying to get somebody to pay attention to her. She falls to the inside, grabs her face, but nobody paid any heed as they kept on going around. OMG WTF now being sent out. Looks like a major elbow. Sexy Slady goes out at the same time, so I'm not sure who the penalty that was assessed to, but two out of the defense for Gotham.
Adam Matrix is out. Bonnie Thunders up front, calls off the jam, scoring 4 more points for Gotham. Makes the score 63-51. But Bam Bam, at its height, it was 51-0 after five jams in this game. Oh, here we see the replay. Bonnie Thunders with a nice move. Up front with Sassy. Comes around, gets the hips in front of hips, and then calls it off. That's all it takes.
If you are tired of sliding through slippery corners, we suggest you try new Radar Fillin' Wheels. You want to get more information, that is radarwheels.com.
So Bonnie Thunders takes her intentional fourth minor as Susie Hartrod is jamming for Gotham, but jamming for Olympia, and out for lead jammer is on to slide.
On to slide coming up in. Susie Hartrod has to recycle herself all the way back. She's got to get past Hockey Honey. She's got to get past Psycho Babble, and she has got to get past deranged.
Which she does, not yeah. On to slide. Was able to score a natural grand slam. So it's Hot Rod out. Here comes On to Slide looking to get one more scoring pass. She does, and will she call it off? She's not done this in the past.
Nope, bench has given her the signal. Keep going.
Oh, solid hit by Psycho Babble there on Hot Rod. Forces her out. On to Slide has got a potential for a jammer lap point here.
Brilliant hold up. On to Slide goes in, spins out. Left foot goes well inside, almost comes in. Has to pull herself back in. Nice bit of a skip there at the very end as well as she gets a pass there, picks up 5 points on that pass.
She does. Susie Hot Rod still stuck in the back. And Ole has taken the lead, 65-63. There's another jammer lap point. Nice apex jump by On to Slide. She sticks the landing and then calls it off.
Has a helmet cover issue. She's got to pull it back up to make sure she can see. She does call it, and the coach goes out very quickly. Looks like he's pointing to the penalty box for some reason. Not quite sure why. They're going to have a conference replay happening right here.
Yep. Up, over, stuck the landing. But I don't know why you call it off there. Hot Rod had scored 4 points, but she had not cleared the pack on that last. She had scored her 4 points. It was her cycle back. You might need those points, Bam Bam. You might need those points.
Well, when you're sitting right now with only a 3-point lead, 70 for Ole, 67 for Gotham, you got to take everything you can get. Adam Matrix is going to try to continue doing that for Ole as she's up in the middle of the pack. She's got one pivot in front of her to assist, and she's able to do so. Adam Matrix is lead jammer, Ole.
Excuse me, that's cleared away. I said Bonnie Thunders, I apologize. Cleared away is wearing the jammer star for Gotham, having no luck on her initial pass as Adam Matrix now begins a scoring run. Oh, Adam Matrix inside, door was open, she's out, was able to get the jammer lap point, is cleared away, clears the pack.
Tanabel Lecter had gone on a fourth minor, so that had thinned it out a little bit for assistance for Ole. Coach gives the signal. They call that off right there. We talked a little bit before about those points coming in, the points per jam average. Atta Matrix at 5.3, Bonnie Thunders at 8. We already know Bonnie's exceeded hers, but when you look at the postseason point total, 437 for Atta Matrix coming into this, 700 for Gotham. So when you're looking at those averages, you've got potential for bigger scoring for both of their bigger points going in favor of Gotham, not showing up right now.
All right, deranged on the jammer line versus Susie Hot Rod. And a major low block is being called. Meanwhile, deranged is out. Hot Rod, it was not on Hot Rod, so Hot Rod does clear the pack. She's not the lead jammer. Half of the laps separate the jammers. Here comes deranged on a scoring run.
Back looking nicely organized toward the front to benefit Gotham. They had a through wall, but it gets broken up very nicely by Psycho Babble as deranged comes through, is able to call it. Picks up 3 points on that pass. That is going to bring our score 67 Gotham, 77 only, 8:30 to play.
So always starting to expand the lead here, Bam Bam.
Indeed they are. And if you want to expand your business as far as leads go, you can get printing and promotional leads taken care of at Printco Graphics, printcographics.com.
8 minutes left in the half. Bonnie Thunders comes to the jammer line for Gotham and Black on the slide for Ole and White.
Bonnie Thunders takes a nice little bit of a step to the outside, moves up to the middle of the pack, pushes forward, and then scoots around the outside as well, as he only had two to get past. She's able to do it. Bonnie Thunders is your lead jammer. Onderslice still caught at the back of the pack, looking for any opportunity, not able to find it, as we've got Fisticuffs doing some nice defense from the pivot in that third position. Recycle back, but Bonnie Thunders through, picks up 5 points.
An all-natural glam slam is on the slide, still trying to make her initial pass through the pack. Sexy Slady Forces are all the way back, but there's another jammer lap point for Bonnie Thunders. Now up front with Lil Tonka and Sassy. Nice job by Sassy, but she's got to be out of play at some point. Bonnie Thunders gets out another grand slam.
And it looks like we are a tie game currently. Gotham 77, only 77. Bonnie Thunders, though, gets through as fast as it takes to say that.
On a slide does clear the pack. Likely the last scoring run for Bonnie Thunders. Solid defense there by Tana Lecter. Thunders calls it off.
Does she get any? She gets a 3-point gain on that. So now Gotham has taken the lead back. 80 points, 77 for Ole. You got to think that we've seen some games this weekend. We're seeing playing like that all weekend. We've got Bonnie Thunders making a little bit of a hop back and forth. She's got one defender just kind of focused. Sassy is not going to let her go, but kind of hard to keep on hold of Bonnie Thunders.
Claire DeWay comes to the jammer line for Gotham. She's been out there twice. She's gotten lead jammer once. Went to the penalty, excuse me. Adamatrix on the line for Ole.
Claire DeWay for Gotham. Adamatrix moving outside. Now gets the two, possibly three wall. They're all so low. It is indeed a three wall. Nice bit of a move as Claire DeWay, unfortunately, struggling with her own three wall in the back. Pack breaks up. Nice bridging because of Gotham. Allows those other two to get out too far. But unfortunately for them, Adamatrix is your lead jammer.
Adamatrix is able to push 20 feet out. Claire DeWay is through as well. Nice move by Adamatrix. Checks with her coaches and calls off the jam. So 4 points there. Makes the score now 80 for Gotham, 81 for Ole.
Yeah, Adamatrix looks like she was going to pull up for a moment. Thought it was the time to do that. She's not. So we're going to see if she gets a nice bit of a hop along the inside against McSpagger. You can see her looking to the bench right there. With the hands, does she call it? She goes, and then that's when they decide time to end that one on that pass because you've got the lead back in your favor. 1 point.
On a slide, taking her intentional fourth minor for Ole, deranged, jamming for Ole in the white, Bonnie Thunders for Gotham in the black. Don't forget, you can vote for the MVP until this half. Bonnie Thunders making a strong case for it, and she's up around lead jammer, Bonnie Thunders.
Though Blazik very closely behind her is the only jammer. She is also through. Nice bit of a push from 27 to range.
Pack picks up speed here. Pack coming around turn four. Here comes Bonnie Thunders. Inside doors wide open. Calls it off. 4 more points for Gotham. Makes the score now another lead change. 84-81 Gotham over Ole.
That is the smart play. You get a couple of inches and you've got to take every one, as we're going to see right here. Nice bit of a hop. She lines it up. She gets the push off pass. Sexy Slady gets through instantly. Has the hands to the hips. Again, you can vote for MVP, blocker, and jammer. We've got just a few minutes left to do that. So please, WFTDA.com/MVP. Get your votes in right now. Just a few minutes left. And at the end of the game, we'll have a presentation of your decision.
Adamatrix versus Susie Hot Rod. Susie Hot Rod is your lead jammer. Adam Matrix does get out. 30 feet separate these very fast-moving jammers. We're down to a micro pack, 2-on-2. Pack moving fairly quickly as well, Bam Bam.
Two little trains moving, both white and black, trying to hold together. At this point, no real reason to try and go into defense. They're both going to just have the jammers chase. You got a little bit of time to burn, but you don't want to do that too much. You can't make them work that hard. With still 4 minutes left to play, you got to start building on some points somewhere.
And Hot Rod is forced to call it off. Solid pack play there by Hockey Honey and I believe Tannibal Lecter. They kept that pack moving so fast, the Gotham blockers were going to be in position.
Sassy. Yes.
Just smart pack play there by Oli. At 3 minutes and 45 seconds left in the first half, still 84 for Gotham, 81 for Olympia.
When you look at the point board, we've got Bonnie Thunder sitting at 62. The next one is 13 points for Cleared Away. Oli, though, spreading the wealth a little bit. We've got Adam Matrix at 43 and On the Slide, 31 points. But between them, contributing to our totals right now, still a three-point game.
And Bonnie Thunders is lead. Jammer for Gotham, deranged, the jamming for Olympia. She's all the way in the back of the pack. Solid defense by Sexy Slady. Slady does go down, but here comes Bonnie Thunders now on a scoring run.
Looks like an illegal procedure being called on deranged. She is being sent, that is Psycho Babble, sent to the penalty box.
And out is Thunders for all 5 points. Deranged still in the back of this pack. Takes an outside line, gets around Slady. Here comes Bonnie Thunders now on her second scoring run. Deranged, though, is out of the pack.
We see Bonnie Thunders looking, again, on her own because defense decides to come up and help. Davey Blockett loosens up, tries to get up in there. Hella Skelter also trying to make a bit of a wedge. But 4 points, Bonnie Thunders calls it very quickly. We now have Gotham at 93. Oli at 81, and we want to talk to you about the Pilot F-16 plate system. You can pick your price and performance. Brought to you by Adam Wheels, proud partner of WFTDA.
Bonnie Thunders again so good with that spin move to the outside, able to keep her forward momentum going, gets the last point and calls it off. That was her second scoring run there, Bam Bam. 9 points in that jam. Is Hot Rod jamming now for Gotham, Adam Matrix for Olympia.
Adam Matrix again has the most points on that team so far. At the back of the pack, though, Susie Hot Rod able to stay in bounds as she lowers herself halfway under the body of the opponent, takes the inside line, keeps her skate in, tucks it nicely as she comes around. But Adam Matrix right behind her, coasting through the corners. Pack starting to break apart.
Oh, it's such a pretty move by Hot Rod through the inside line. The Gotham defense able to open those doors up for her. 4 more points for Gotham as they start to build this lead back up. Now 97-81 with a minute and a half left, and here's Hot Rod. So pretty on that inside line, yep. Keeps it in bounds.
That's the thing you've got to do. We saw that affect Bonnie Thunders earlier. She made the move, just grazed across that edge. Cannot do it, Bonnie Thunders again. We have got On the Sly for Oli at the jam line.
Thunders now up front with a two-wall. The multiplayer block is called. Bonnie Thunders is released. She is lead jammer. On the Sly is still in the back of the pack, Bam Bam.
Donna Matrix being sent outside. She has to go to the penalty box for Gotham.
Oh, huge hit! Sexy Slady on the Sly. On the Sly gets up, checks the jammer cap, sees if it still is on. Bonnie Thunders now on a scoring run. On the Sly still on her initial pass. There's a jammer lap point. And Bonnie Thunders picks up a grand slam.
Tannibal Lecter comes in for Oli, making it a 4-on-3 advantage for them.
On the slice.
One wheel.
Stays in bounds. So that is her initial pass. Here's Thunders on yet another scoring run. Calls it off with 23 seconds left. It'll take a timeout by one of the teams to get another jam in this half.
Waiting to see. It looks like we have the replay right
there. Sexy Slade, such a hit. And it was legal. The target was inbounds, hit her in a legal target zone.
Beautiful thing. So we are winding down with about 3 seconds left. I don't see anybody coming out. No reason to call this. Except for time, and that is going to lead us, I believe, into our half. Gotham, 104 points, only at 81.
So much to talk about here, Bam Bam. Both teams have all three of their timeouts. Neither team used an official review in that first half. Very, very quick moving, 30 minutes of game clock. If you want to vote for the MVP, you need to go there right now and do it. WFTDA.com/MVP. Vote for your blocker and jammer MVP for the entire tournament.
I think that we have to look at consideration. Those two might be certainly heavily favored out of these two teams. I mean, when you look at the points totals that have been put up by a couple of these skaters, certainly Bonnie Thunders is going to be one. But you also have to look at the defense that Sexy Slady has been able to put up. But when you look at the way that Oli's been playing, again, aggressive. When they're able to make those hits, they really can stick them. They can make them count. So I think it's really going to be able to open it up either way for the voting. So we're going to be able to tabulate some of our own unofficial stats for you when we come back at our half. But in the meantime...
Well, let me tell you about a couple things here, Bam Bam.
Yes.
Both teams have spent 16 minutes in the penalty box each. 16 minutes for each team total. Penalty box been such a huge factor so far in this game. Gotham opened up this game after four jams, 38-0. They did it on the back of three trips to the penalty box by Adam Atrix while wearing the jammer star for Olympia. With those three power jams, Bonnie Thunders was able to score 20 points in one jam, 15 in another, and Claire DeWay was able to pick up 13 points in the third. That was obviously a huge part of them building that lead. Since those three trips to the penalty box by the Olympia Jammers, Oli has sent no jammers to the penalty box. Since those three trips by the Oli Jammers, Gotham has gone twice. When Olympia was on the power jam, they were able to score 29 points and only 8 points in their second power jam. But Olympia is able to chip away, start to stay out of the penalty box, play much cleaner than we saw in those first few jams. So I'll be curious to see how they extend this as we go.
And we're going to find that when we come back to our second half of action. One last time, this is your last opportunity, WFTDA.com/MVP. Go there right now, and then meet us back here in about 10 minutes. And as we come back, Kool-Aid, we want to take a quick look at our scores. You've got some stats for us. We have our leading point scorers, Bonnie Thunders, 78 points. On the other side, we've got Adam Atrix at 43. What other good numbers you got?
Bonnie Thunders, so good. She was out there for 10 jams, was able to pick up lead jammer status in seven of those. The three jams that she did not get lead jammer, she spent in the penalty box, as Oli was able to take very good advantage of their power jam, keeping her in the box essentially for three jams. You know, and we talked earlier before we went to the break, Adam Atrix initially such horrible, horrible penalty trouble, but she has cleaned up her act. Three trips to the box to start off with, and since then, none.
Yes, I think that we had those within the first three jams. She was already in there twice. Came back, had that one more time, and she's been able to hold it up, and we see that being effective as being able to put those points on the board. But Tanabel Lecter, four trips. We've got four other with three. Again, Adam Atrix, we've got Psychobabble, you've got Hockey Honey, you've got Joy Collision. When you look on the other side, Gotham, not as many. They have a few more ones or single digits, but you've got Donna Matrix at two, Mick Swagger at three, OMGWTF at three, and that's about it.
You know, we also saw Brazilian Nut take the Jammer Star for Gotham. She had, a fairly rough day against Denver yesterday. I don't have the full stats in front of me, but not an effective game jamming for Gotham. She's only been out there twice, only was in there for two jams because the one jam she started as the jammer on the jammer line went to the penalty box, and Oli was able to extend that power jam into the next jam. So looks like we got some viewers from all around the world on WFTDA.tv.
We want to thank you if you're watching anywhere in the world, but also if you're in Australia, Ireland, Sweden, our neighbors to the North, Canada, New Zealand, and India. We want to thank you. Let us know what you think if you want. You're going to be a little bit longer to do hashtag talk to WFTDA. We appreciate all the words that you're putting up right there, your feelings about this game so far. As we come back to it in a few minutes, Gotham 104, Oli is at 81.
Now, if you were watching the high-quality clock here on WFTDA.tv, you have noticed that we've magically turned back time. In honor of Cher, Bam Bam, we have turned back time.
Somebody needs to honor her.
And since we're going to honor Cher, we're going to go ahead and reboot the Ringster stats, which might be the actual reason we're doing this. So we're going to hold here for just a couple of more minutes while we get Ringster back up and running. We know the stats have been immensely popular for you folks at home. And let's thank some partners.
We have some people that help bring us this tournament, the season so far that has been presented to you on WFTDA.tv. And we want to take one more opportunity to make sure that we thank them particularly. Fast Girl Skates, Sisu Mouthguards, 5 on 5 Magazine, Derby Skins, Five Stride Skate Shop, Sin City Skates, Cruise Skate Shop, Blood and Thunder Magazine, S1 Helmets, Wicked Skatewear, Bont Boots, Vanilla Skates, and Derby for All in particular. Thank you so much for helping us bring to the world the 2012 championship on WFTDA.tv.
We should also again thank Jammer Up Board Game for providing us not only the prizes for the Bracket Bonanza winners, but a pretty awesome Derby board game. We'd also like to thank Union Vacations for sending the grand champion to Milwaukee next year. They've also sent someone here. I haven't actually had a chance to talk to her. And, of course, 2-in-1 Skate Shop. Find them on the web at the number 2, the letter N, the number 1, Skate Shop. Shop with two P's and an E, .com. They're in Alaska, actually, but they will ship all over the world. Really awesome shop. You should check out their merchandise. They do some great stuff. And, of course, they were a key sponsor, in fact, the sponsor of the Bracket Bonanza.
And, again, we have two perfect brackets so far, though I believe they both picked Gotham.
Both picked Gotham. We actually had the first time this year, we had four perfect brackets last year at Champs. And everyone saw Gotham and only making their way through as they did. This year we had our first regional perfect bracket, mm-hmm. which no one had done last year. We only had one of those the entire 2012 season. So looks like we're about to get back to it, Bam Bam. Deranged comes to the Jammer line again for Oli in the white. Bonnie Thunders in the black for Gotham. Deranged has been out there five times as Jammer. Only gotten lead Jammer once. And has scored only 7 points for Oli.
Nice bit of an early nudge from Deranged to kind of move Bonnie Thunders over. They hold back, reset. Bonnie Thunders tries to push on the outside. Deranged moves up along the inside. Bonnie Thunders has to pull herself back around. Now gets pushed to the inside, spins it. Nice little bit of a move. But pushing ever forward is Deranged. She is your lead jammer for Oli in the white.
Bonnie Thunders does just now get out of the pack. Almost half of a lap separate the jammers. 4-on-2 in the pack. Deranged comes up, front gets into a wall with Sexy Slady and OMG. Bonnie Thunders now hits the Oli 4 wall in the back. 4 points for Deranged on that pass. Makes the score 85 for Oli, 104 for Gotham.
And nice defense for Oli right there. They were able to hold Bonnie Thunders for those few extra seconds it was necessary to make sure that Deranged got through to get all of those points. So again, we sit 104 Gotham, 85 Oli. This is to determine, of course, the champion. We've had Oli come in here. They've won in 2009. They lost by a point in 2010. We have the reigning champion, Gotham, and we get back to it.
We got Susie Hot Rod jamming for Gotham. Tannable Lecter is jamming for Oli. Tannable had a baby 3 weeks ago. 3 weeks, not months, not years, weeks ago, and she's out there wearing the Jammer Star. 3-on-3 in the pack. Slow start to begin with. Hot Rod is up front. Lecter is in the back.
We had that conversation with Tannable Lecter earlier. She's got that hernia brace on to support the muscle girdle, slowing her down just a little bit. But Susie Hot Rod able to push around. She is your lead jammer. Pack breaks open. Tannable Lecter has a little bit of an opportunity, and she takes it right there. She gets around fisticuffs, 241 for Gotham. She is now out, and Susie Hot Rod now engaging. Gets a bit of a bump. And keeps going.
Hot Rod up front with a Olympia 2-wall. Here comes Tannable Lecter approaching the pack. Hot Rod needs to call it off. She does. 3 points, I believe. Yeah, 3 points for Susie Hot Rod. Runs the score now 107 for Gotham, 85 for Olympia with just under 28 minutes left in the game.
So we saw this just a few minutes ago. They put Bonnie Thunders out against Deranged on a quick assignment change in the pack. It looked very full. They looked at the boxes and said that's a couple too many, so they've got to pull some back in. So we only have 2 out there for Gotham, 3 out there for Oli. People are exchanging knees up and down. Either way, the jam still gets off from the get-go. Bonnie Thunders pushes on the outside. She's got a 2-and-3 wall assist as McSwagger comes in to even up the odds a little bit for Gotham.
Bam Bam, Deranged is your lead jammer, but was pulled back into the pack. So Deranged working her way towards the front, trying to get past McSwagger, unable to do so. Gets forced out of bounds, and Deranged just calls it off. Bonnie Thunders had not cleared the pack. Bam Bam, I don't mean to harp on this, but we've seen this before from Deranged. Not 100% effort when she doesn't feel like it. There was no reason to call it off there. She had positional advantage on Bonnie Thunders. Bonnie Thunders had not cleared the pack, but she just said, nah, calls it off, and we're going to do it again. No points scored for either team.
You know, we can speculate at this point. She just thought she didn't have the advantage as she got into the pack. There's no reason to make that much effort in a foot race when you've got still 26 minutes left to play. could be an issue of conservation of energy at this point because they've got a 22-point deficit to come from.
I suppose that could be it. Adamatrix versus Claredaway. Adamatrix up front, Claredaway in the back. Three wall by Gotham now spreading out as they begin to bridge. Adamatrix is out. Lead jammer, Adamatrix.
We've got Claredaway going on. Knee gets slid to the outside, gets back up, and the pack opens up almost for her. She's a nice bit of a hop on the last blocker for Oli. Pack pulls itself in as Adamatrix pushed it basically back together. She came into play, looks to the bench, gets the call it off. Zero gain for Gotham and 4 points for Oli, bringing them up. Gotham 107, Oli 89.
So to the range comes to the jammer line for the third time in this half. We've yet to see on the slide jamming for Oli thus far, deranged apparently in a two-jammer rotation with Adamatrix.
Bonnie Thunders looks to clear the slate as she is going for an intentional fourth minor.
107-89, just under 26 minutes left. Good defense here by Mick Swagger on deranged. Hockey Honey doing a nice job on Hot Rod. Oh, and out is deranged for lead jammer Olympia.
Susie Hot Rod at the back of the pack gets a nice bit of a move at the last moment past Hockey Honey. It's open up the middle and she goes right through it as we've got deranged coming into the pack. She's got three to get past as the two for Oli just back up. She's able to do just that. Gets a nice fake out on Hyperlinks, who is sent off to the box. OMG tries to hold it, is not able to do it. Oli comes out, calls it off right there. They are now up by four more points, 93. We see our replay. We've got deranged coming in, moving to the outside. Gets past Mick Swagger. OMG holds up for a second and loses momentum, cannot catch up.
Looks like Hyperlinks was trying to come in and grab the hit, but she was able to juke around it. So we've got Brazilian Nut coming back to the jammer line for the third time in this game for Gotham. And Adamatrix comes to the jammer line for Olympia.
And penalty is still a big factor. We've got two on two pack right now.
We've got one Olympia blocker standing, so nice time for Oli to do a slow start. On the slide is released from the box.
But she does not cause the pack to move forward. She's behind the jammer line for a moment there. Gets Oli, in position.
Oli's fourth blocker is standing, so smart play here by Oli. There are the whistles. Adamatrix initially up front. All four blockers now out for Oli. Adamatrix is up. Brazilian Nut was able to get through for lead jammer, Bam Bam.
You know, everybody's focusing on what Oli was doing. Brazilian Nut just able to use her size and just kind of, don't pay attention to me. Gets around, but decides to call it there. Adamatrix had caught up to her. And again, it's the idea. You had an advantage and you can lose it that quickly. Do you want to try and force something or do you say, you know what?
That was a smart call off by Brazilian Nut with the pack advantage being what it was. We see here the replay. Good defense, and Brazilian Nut found the outside line wide open, was able to cut around it for lead jammer. When you're at that pack disadvantage, that's a great time to call it off and reset it, do it again.
Yep, you've got 14-point lead right now as Gotham is at 107, Oli is at 93, 23-30 left to play.
Deranged versus Bonnie Thunders, Gotham in the black, Olympia in the white. Scrum starts to begin with. Bonnie Thunders is so good as these as Mick Swagger forces Deranged out. Bonnie Thunders trying to get past Hockey Honey, not having a great deal of success.
Not so much. Deranged at the back of the three wall, tries to then move the inside line, not quite able to do it. Bonnie Thunders is just getting past, but from out of nowhere, nice bit of contact from Psychobabble.
Bonnie Thunders is the lead jammer, but was forced all the way out by a Deranged and Echo. Does now complete her initial pass.
Echo gets set to the box for blocking out of bounds.
So Deranged still working on an initial pass through the pack. Whistle starting to build up. And is that on Deranged?
I believe it is.
It is.
You can see her stand up and just tip her head down as she gets a fourth minor. That is a back block. That is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4 to send her to the penalty box. So we have a pass happening now, power jam style, for Bonnie Thunders.
Nice hit there by Psychobabble. No packs briefly called. Psychobabble has to let her go. Just Joy, Collision, and Psycho out there for Olympia. All four blockers on the track for Gotham. Here comes Bonnie Thunders looking for a third scoring run.
Mick Swagger says just move it aside, open the curtain, and Bonnie Thunders is able to squeak through, tries to move the outside. Psychobabble sees it, moves herself into position. Joy, Collision also plays more of a shoving, doesn't want to get in the way, but makes sure that Psychobabble is able to do so.
And a major multiplayer block being called on Joy, Collision.
And that's what happens.
As Bonnie Thunders gets around for another scoring point. Hockey Honey is released from the box, as is Echo, so Joy will have a place to sit as here's Thunders on another scoring run.
Fortuitous timing again for Ole as one pops out, one goes back in. Bonnie Thunders gets through, doesn't call it, but one more peels off for the defense of Ole on a five-point pass of Bonnie Thunders. She gets the call from Buster Cheaton. She says, call it off right then and there. So Ole is going to sit at 93 points. Gotham is going to pull away 127 as we see Bonnie Thunders here on the replay. Bounce shoulder to shoulder with Psycho Babble.
So D-Range stands in the penalty box wearing the Jammer Star for Olympia. Only two blockers out there wearing the white for Ole. All four Gotham blockers are out, as is Susie Hot Rod. And it looks like we've got a official timeout.
It looks as though Tripp was going over to the box and saying that blocker who is seated is getting a second minute for insubordination. Not exactly sure what exactly, when we'll get confirmation, but I believe that is Psycho Babble.
That is.
21, having a little bit of an argument.
No stranger to the intermittent insubordination call.
And here comes the slide whistle. That's our official, here we go.
Nice play there by Joy Collision to sort of steer deranged around. Steer Psycho Babble around.
Yep, but the lockup right there as we see.
Yep,
you can blatantly see the hand over the hand.
That's the multiplayer block that was called on Joy Collision.
So we have still the official timeout. We have got Endless Justin out there talking to the pack as they're all on a knee. Susie Hot Rod with the Jam Star out there for Gotham. I see just two, of course, for Ole standing at the front. I believe Tannabelle Lecter and Sassy. As we've got two in the box, we do have Deranged standing with the Star. And 21:05 left in our second half, our championship game. 127 Gotham, 93 for Ole. Thank you to everyone watching on WFTDA.tv.
I'm willing to bet that at least a few of the watch parties all around the world right now, as folks are checking out the high-quality feed on WFTDA.tv, I have to imagine this, at least 30% of them are doing the whoop.
I can only hope so, and hopefully they're wearing some fantastic merchandise from the WFTDA. If you want to get tournament merchandise from all of the regional playoffs and even championships here, even just a shirt that says WFTDA, let them know the sport that's on the grow. You can remember these awesome times and many more to come in our new seasons. Going to WFTDA.com to check out the merchandise store. That is WFTDA.com. Tell them where you've been by wearing a t-shirt.
All right, again, 127-93, 21 minutes left in the game. Susie Hot Rod jamming all by herself. Not any longer as Deranged does join her. Four wall for Gotham, two wall for Ole.
Deranged comes in, she loses her footing. She goes back down in front of Donna Matrix, but there's 1, 2, 3, 4 to get past. Sexy Slady just kind of waiting on the outside, and it pays off nicely as Susie Hot Rod is able to get around and become the lead jammer. Deranged, in the meantime, gets past Sexy Slady on the outside, gets up into the middle of the pack, but then it falls apart around her to resurface in front of her. But she does get through on that pass, but Susie Hot Rod is right behind on her scoring run, picking up four.
Looks like Susie Hot Rod wants the fifth jammer lap point. She gets it easily as Deranged was not skating hard at all. So now Hot Rod has a chance to get another scoring run. There's four more points. Deranged on a scoring run as well. Excuse me, 5 points, pardon me.
Yep, because she had picked up the one before she had entered the pack down to range. So the fifth one that applies to that. So that's going to be 9 point pass on that run. 3 point pickup for Ole. That's going to take them 96. There's the bump. Susie Hot Rod, Sassy with a nice bit of a face on that one. Tannabelle Lecter makes a bit of a contact. So Gotham, 136, Double H.
Right, you guys were actually right. That last timeout was reviewing Psycho Babble's minutes in the box, and she did get an additional minute for insubordination for not leaving the track quickly enough when her fourth minor was assessed, guys.
So we got Bonnie Thunders versus Adamatrix, 136-96. Adamatrix gets lead jammer. First time in four jams that Ole's gotten at Bam Bam.
And that is after a nice shakeoff of OMG WTF, who gets knocked to the inside, 753 for Gotham. She's back up as Adamatrix now is going to come back into the pack. Bonnie Thunders finally through. She's got to get back around, though. Adamatrix, she's going to get through. I don't think it's going to be wise to call it off, but they decide to do that. They've got some ground to make up for. I think, you know, you've got those points. Do you want to take that little gain, or do you want to say, we've held Bonnie on one pass? There's no guarantee you're going to get to a second.
No. Yeah, I like that call off. You're not down by that much. See a nice replay here. Adamatrix so strong on her skates. Almost took a tumble, was able to stay up and get through. So, yeah, I like that call off. You want to save clock more than you want to gamble on Bonnie Thunders getting through.
Yeah, and especially when you consider you've got 18 plus left to go.
That's the time to do it.
So On the Sly is your lead jammer for Ole. This is the first time we've seen her in this half jamming for the white and brown. Meanwhile, Claire DeWay is your jammer for Gotham. She is towards the front of the pack, but here's On the Sly on a scoring run.
Tanab Elector was almost able to stay in front of Claire DeWay. She gets knocked down. On the Sly, nice bit of hopping around. She is still at the back of the pack. Slady comes across, knocks her out, goes down herself. So On the Sly is able to get through, and just around the outside of Anabolics very well, picks up 4 points and calls it.
Solid first jam of the second half for On the Sly. Runs her point total now to 31 points in this game. Makes it 104 to 136. Gotham over Ole, 18 minutes left in the game.
We came back into this game. Bonnie Thunders had over 70 points. She is still at 78. So it seems as though Ole may have started to figure out a little bit of the runaway point scoring for Bonnie Thunders, as we have Adamatrix still also at 43, where she came in, if I'm not mistaken, at the pack. So we'll get an update on those sticks. They might be a minute or two behind.
And Bonnie Thunders is not the lead jammer for Gotham, because Adamatrix is your lead jammer for Ole. Adamatrix, Bonnie Thunders is out. About 60 feet separate the jammers. A slow moving pack. Only one blocker out there for Ole right now. All four out for Gotham. Adamatrix is in, checks Bonnie Thunders. Calls it off, but I think Thunders might have got, nope, no points for Bonnie Thunders. Three more points for Ole. So Ole now starting to make a play, Bam Bam, as they're coming back into this game one jam at a time.
Well, you've got 29 point difference happening. We have a replay right now seeing Adamatrix caught up in the middle, gets a nice bit of a almost pass around hyperlinks, just hides to call it again. You got that edge, you're going into the apex, you know you're on the outside. It's going to make that much more work. Good timing on the call off. Gotham 136, Ole 107.
Also, Bonnie Thunders had only two Olympia blockers in the back, so those were that first blocker would have been worth a lot of points. Deranged on the jammer line for Ole. And out there for Gotham is Susie Hot Rod. She's out. She is lead jammer.
We have got
Deranged does get out. Little demonstrative hit there after Slady was able to put a little bit of contact on her. Here comes Hot Rod now into the pack. Oh, nice move by Hot Rod. Spins around on the outside line. That's worth 4 points. Score now 140 to 107. 16 minutes left in the game. Bam Bam.
Interesting maneuvering happening right here. Susie Hot Rod on the pass on the replay gets spun out, calls the jam during the spin. Realizes she hears whistles and just lets it go. That loss of momentum, 16 minutes. We can see now Adamatrix on the line in the white for Ole. 340 Bonnie Thunders in the black. A few seconds to go. I see three defenders out there for Gotham and Ole, one for Ole.
Now two as Joy Collision was standing. She's rejoined the pack and no pack is called. Your lead jammer is Bonnie Thunders for Gotham.
Joy Collision has to let her go. She's well outside the zone of engagement. She gets the pass. Though we have Adamatrix back up on her feet and through. Bonnie Thunders, though, has some nice swift movement. Does the pack, as they've done before, starts to move quicker and quicker away. Mick Schrager comes up and calls it up.
Oh! Bonnie Thunders knocked into the air, out of bounds, slid across the track line, wisely did not get up, Bam Bam, just called it from a seating position, avoided the track cut, makes the score now 143 to 107 with 15 minutes left.
And the stats that I have here, a little bit more current than the last time I mentioned them. We want to thank Ringster for making sure that we have those correct. Bonnie Thunders is actually over 100 points now. She's at 101, though Adamatrix is up 54, so 11 points more. We see the replay happening. Bonnie Thunders gets spun to the inside and out as she puts her hands to her hips. So we have seen some movement. We have got penalty trouble looking a little bit heavier for Ole. Again, we're going to have a total in a minute to see where those settle up as Professor Murder's calling in everybody, circling the wagons to see exactly what issue we're having right now with our penalties.
Well, I saw Gotham initially whistle a timeout. I'm not sure if they're going to change this to an official review. We'll find out shortly. Thus far, box minutes starting to pile up for Olympia. Last time we checked, they were even at the halftime, I believe. 13 minutes each. Be that as may, as it is now, 32 box minutes for Olympia, 23 for Gotham. Ole needs, must, absolutely have to stay out of the box.
Yeah. They were very parallel. I believe at one point it was 8 and 9.
At halftime, it was 16
and 16. Yeah, doubling that already for Ole. Just a few more for Gotham.
Psycho Babble with 5 trips to the box. Recall she had the double major penalty got a minute for insubordination, so that counts as two trips to the box. She's got five. With 15 minutes left in the game, she's going to have to clean it up, or she's at risk of fouling out when she gets to that seventh trip to the box.
And you've got four people with four trips to the penalty box for Ole, only two on Gotham's side. So we see right now, nice hustle right there for Adam Atrick. She is your lead jammer. Bonnie Thunner's looking to get around, and she is able to get over the top of Psycho Babble, as a matter of fact. The cycle plays out in front of her.
So Adam Atrick now looks for a scoring one. Only one blocker now, two out there for Gotham. Adam Atrick calls it off. 4 points. So at Olympia not going away. Absolutely not going away here, as we see the Bonnie Thunders with a nice move. Psycho Babble kind of took a...
You know,
I didn't see a whole lot of contact before the fall.
I give her credit, though, for tucking the arms and tucking the face under, you know.
All right, on the slide comes to the jammer line for Olympia.
143 Gotham, 111 Ole, 14 to play.
Susie Hot Rod jamming for Gotham. On the slide, outside line. She's out lead. Jammer on the slide for the Ole Rollers. Susie Hot Rod now. Oh, nice move to get past Hannibal. She's out. Half of a lap. Separate these jammers.
Susie Hot Rod doing her very best to catch up. Pack again, moving quickly. Ole realizes, though, oh, our jammer's first, so they start to slow back down. And that's where Donna Matrix and Mick Swager start to move a little bit faster. Not enough time, so they have to go into a defensive position rather than a race. They do hold the pack up successfully enough for Susie Hot Rod to now enter into the pack.
So both jammers look at the score points. On a slide, finishes a pass, and is not calling it off. So Hot Rod, and I agree with that non-caught off. Here's Hot Rod now, and on the slide gets past her. There's a jammer lap point on the slide around Mick Swager on the slide. 5 point grand slam.
Nice bit of assist. Hannibal Lecter's doing a great job holding back Susie Hot Rod. Anabolics comes in from outside, pushes her out of the way, loosens up the noose a little bit, but it takes at least half a track for Susie Hot Rod to get around to pick up 4 points. And that's enough time for on the slide to come back in now at the back of the pack.
Mm-hmm. And on the slide does get past the 1 point. That one blocker should be worth three. It is.
It is indeed. So we have the Gothic World Roller Derby timeout. Number 404, Hyperlinks, thought she was assessed a major, but it was a minor, so she was taken out of the box. So that was what that timeout was called for. So there was clarification. Hyperlinks, it's a major, it's a minor. She gets to come back out.
It's on the slide with that nice juke around Mick Swager on the outside. So D-range comes the jammer line for Ole. Bonnie Thunders for Gotham. 147-123 for Gotham in the black over Ole in the white. The jam has started. 12 minutes left in this game, Bam Bam.
Gotham at one point did have a much more substantial lead. It's starting to erode a little bit.
And a jammer, we've got a jammer star pass to Adam Atrick, who is not eligible for lead because she was past the star. That means Bonnie Thunders, who is in the pack, is still eligible for lead, but she's going to have to clear this pack. She's going to have to do it quickly. Adam Atrick there scores 1 point. Bonnie Thunders gets lead, calls it off. 2 points were scored by Adam Atrick. One for the blocker she passed, one for the ghost point in the penalty box. Good play there by Ole.
And again, one of the questions is that a great thing to stall? People aren't expecting those quick breaks. You get the reach. As long as you're perspective and you've got that arm length, mm-hmm. you can do it that quickly. So credit goes to, I think, Adam Atrick for being in position to quickly receive, switch and go.
Well, it's really a set play when you've got Gotham lining up at their three wall right on the the jammer line. It's the perfect way to hand the pass over that wall, and then Adam Atrick is able to just go. You give up lead jammer status, but it worked out there. Bonnie Thunders is your jammer for Gotham, and another star pass. Ole said we could do this again as Tannable takes the star pass. Does not work this time. It's Bonnie Thunders is your lead jammer and your jammer in the lead about 10 feet in front of Tannable.
But Tannable's keeping a fairly decent pace, so it looks like we are looking for a major on Tannable, who is the jammer.
This is bad news for Olympia, as there's the first of what may be many grand slams for Bonnie Thunders.
Maybe an outside of the zone of engagement when she put the helmet on. It took him a moment to assess that. It looks like he was given to the hatchet arm, and we'll get clarification. But either way, Tannable is in the box. Shoveler is telling her why. He's pointing to the helmet cover. We'll find out again. But 5 points right now for Bonnie Thunders. She coming back around to the pack. Sexist Lady just waits. She knows Bonnie can do it on her own.
As another grand slam, that is correct, Bam Bam. Deranged was the jammer for Ole at the start of this jam. She is sitting in the jammer chair in the penalty box. There had to have been an illegal star pass. Here comes Bonnie Thunders, another scoring run, only three Oli blockers. There's a track cut called on one of the Oli blockers, another grand slam, and a legal star pass. The initiator of the pass is responsible for the legality of the pass. So DeRange goes to the box there. Another scoring run here for Bonnie Thunders.
Indeed, and she's able to get around those two. She's got Hockey Honey and Echo. She's able to pass, though we have got number 27, DeRange, coming back in as she has served a minute during all of that time. Tannibel still out. She's got the pivot stripe on her helmet now.
So DeRange does get out. Bonnie Thunders looks for another scoring run here.
Tannibel is on her feet, trying to enter at the back of the pack. Here she comes.
And as Bonnie Thunders calls it off again, this is all speculation, ma'am, ma'am. I could be incorrect here.
We're getting confirmation now.
So DeRange goes for the illegal star pass, and then Tannibel goes essentially a minor out of play as she skates away from the pack, becomes a major out of play as she fails to return to the pack. Even though she has the jammer star on her head, she is not, in fact, the jammer.
And that is basically the concern, is that she believes that she is, and that's the transition from the minor to the major, because as she is skating forward, and that is why it took that long to actually show up as the major, as they were waiting a count in.
All right, on to Sly on the jammer line versus Susie Hot Rod. 176-125, 9 minutes left in the season. Susie Hot Rod is out. She is lead jammer.
We're looking now. I believe that was Fisticuffs trying to get a backlock call on Onda Sly, not able to do it. Onda Sly now spinning around the inside, almost able to do it. Nice move, though, from Sweet Sherry Pie.
Beautiful hit by Sherry Pie as Hot Rod gets around for a five-point grand slam. OMG goes to the penalty box. Onda Sly finishes her pass. That was her initial run. So Hot Rod comes in for her second scoring pass.
8:25 left to go. Susie Hot Rod along the inside. She almost gets bumped out, but she keeps the skate up in the air, so she does not step out of bounds. She picks up a few points on that pass. No points for Oli, so they are 125. Gotham inching away, 185. It is now a 60-point game. That replay happening. Susie Hot Rod, as you can see, moves that edge.
So strong there is Susie Hot Rod in Olympia. That was the last thing they needed. That power jam may turn out to be the difference. Let's go ahead and get the final clarification on the episode in the penalty box.
So very dramatic, right? So what happened in that jam, as the jammer began, she actually committed a major penalty and then passed the star. And so it was, in fact, an illegal star pass. And the receiver of that star, of course, the pivot, was then assessed a penalty.
Well, there we have it.
So unable to complete the star pass because she was technically out of play, as she should have been going to the penalty box. Adamatrix versus Bonnie Thunders. Bonnie Thunders gets the initial advantage. She is out for lead jammer. Only 5 feet behind her and closing quickly is Adamatrix.
Again, I think smart. You're there. You've got a few minutes. You don't need to burn clock because you've got 60 points. Might as well cut it and reset. You want always build, always run away, especially when you're playing against Oli right now.
Well, you know, again, a 60-point lead with under 8 minutes left. Absolutely to your advantage to just call the jam, let 30 seconds of clock tick away. Bonnie Thunders and Adamatrix didn't even attempt to go back to their bench. They both skated immediately to the jammer line, so we're going to do it again. Three blockers out there for Gotham, two for Oli. Almost to the pivot line. There's the whistles. We're off.
Bonnie Thunders moves from the inside to the outside. She cuts across now. She's just behind Adamatrix. She's just spinning around looking for any opportunity as Adamatrix still trying to just push up that middle.
Oh, and Bonnie Thunder's so good. She's lead jammer, able to shove off one last hit from Psychobabble.
Hockey Honey being sent out in the meantime for Oli.
Adamatrix trying to complete her initial pass here. Mick Swagger so good in the back of the pack. Huge hit by Mick Swagger, and that's a major track cut. That is a major track cut on Adamatrix. We saw the call, Bam Bam. That was the right call by the refs. Bonnie Thunder's now on a power jam. Gets through for a 4-point pass, Bam Bam.
Fisticuffs comes right behind the pivot for Oli with a Gotham with a tiny gun, saying, but she's got to sit down as well. So we have a 2-on-2 Echo out there right now. She is also up against Psychobabble. Bonnie Thunders, though, is able to spin around as she's got another defender coming in. OMG WTF going to be hanging back with Mick Swagger and Anabolic. So it looks like Mick Swagger now being set up for a fourth minor.
There's a out of play failure for him. Here's Bonnie Thunders now. Only two Oli blockers out there. See a minor multiplayer block being called. Echo trying to drop back to bridge. Good hit. Good hit by Psychobabble. But Thunders able to get up as Psychobabble goes to the penalty box, skating so slowly to the penalty box for a major low block. Yeah. Minute doesn't start till you sit down. Meanwhile, Bonnie Thunders takes advantage of this time working on another scoring run.
Heck, as you can see on your screen, now had moved slow and started to edge away. You've got Sassy, has got to let her go, pulls herself up. She does not want to also be sent to the penalty box. Five more points for Bonnie Thunders. That is going to take them over 200 as a timeout is called by Ole. I think the time to do it.
And there is the penalty.
The
I believe Psychobabble was trying to sprawl, maybe to draw a foul of her own, but you know, Ole now down 204 to 125. We saw this last year, Bam Bam. Gotham picked up a substantial lead. I believe it was Adamatrix who had the jammer star in the last jam for Olympia. She actually had lead jammer in that game. They had no timeouts left, and she called off the jam with about 15 seconds left, and Ole essentially, you know, I hate to throw them under the bus, but really they just gave up in that last jam. I wonder if they have the fight in them to come back from this deficit, 204-125, only 5.5 minutes left. They do have two timeouts, but I wonder if they've got the spirit to come back.
But when you think about it, that is 5.5 minutes to somehow find 79 points unanswered against Gotham. This game is all in caps indeed is the sign in our audience here.
All right, Susie Hot Rod jamming unopposed. Adamatrix is standing in the penalty box wearing the jammer star for Olympia. Two blockers out for each team.
Hot Rod with a low crouch. She gets the double whistle and she is off. Again, got to watch out for the multiplayer block. They're able to make sure they do not get that. Susie Hot Rod is able to get around. She is your lead jammer. Though, jammer coming very quickly for Ole.
That's Adamatrix. She is out, came out of the penalty box. 40 feet behind Susie Hot Rod in closing. Olympia doing a great job of moving this pack speed along very quickly, but they are preserving points, but they are also burning clock at the same time. And Hot Rod calls it off. Not a bad time to do it. 204 to 125, still under 5 minutes left in this game.
So we look at Bonnie Thunders has 150 points so far. Biggest point scorer is Adamatrix on the other side at 58. Iron Doll Clothing, a custom uniforms for the modern roller girl and referee, lifting and separating since 2009.
So Bonnie Thunders versus On a Sly. Bonnie Thunders at 149 points. She has outscored the entire Ole team. On a Sly in the back now comes around. On a Sly is working her way towards the front on the outside, but Bonnie Thunders is on the inside. Bonnie Thunders lead jammer for Gotham.
Four minutes left.
On a Sly, it looks like the jammer star fell off. She picked it up, no penalty assessed. She's back in. This is still her initial pass as Thunders comes around for her first scoring run.
A couple of small whistles happening, but nothing major right now. 204-125 in Gotham's favor. And five more points going to go up because of Bonnie Thunders. Big low block right there.
That was a, I believe, anabolics.
Yes.
Thunders now trying to make her way on another scoring run. On the Slide is finally out of the pack. Nice move out to inside by Bonnie Thunders. Checks on the Slide, waits a second, and then calls it off. Olympia uses one of their last two timeouts. Great time to use it. 3 minutes, 25 seconds left as the clock stops. Oh, and we see the replay of On a Sly. Such a huge hit.
With 3 minutes, 25 seconds left to go, our score 213 for Gotham. Ole, 125 Kool-Aid.
I want to apologize to Davey Blockett. I called her anabolics. That was Davey Blockett with that solid hit on a Sly to close out that last jam there. So D-Range comes to the jammer line again for Ole. She's been very heavily favored in this rotation in the second half, not nearly as much of On to Sly as we saw in the first half in Olympia's prior games. Who else? Susie Hot Rod jamming for Gotham.
Green Monster Roller Sports wants you to know if you're skating on crap, it's not from them. Go find some not crap at greenmonster.com. That is greenmonster.com with no vowels, well, except for the O. But
all right, so again, 213 to 125, 3 minutes, 25 seconds left. Just as a housekeeping note, Psychobabble is out right now as the pivot for Olympia. She's got six trips to the box, one more and she's gone, as does Hockey Honey.
Adamatrix with five, Joy Collision with five as well.
Both jammers now skating. Solid defense. Walsh set up by the teams up front. Now is deranged. She's able to get through. Lead jammer is deranged for Oli.
Well out in front. Oh, Susie Hotrod tries to make a bit of a push. Skate goes out from under her. Falls flat, but gets up very, very quickly. Lots of energy there as they are coming close to another championship.
Deranged as the jammer with a solid hit on fisticuffs from her way through. I'm seeing Oli starting to turn up the intensity on the hits. I question how much they're trying to get points and how much they're just trying to put some hurt on Gotham as this game ticks to a close. Now under 3 minutes left in the game.
Definitely the more physical game happening with just a little time left. Deranged is getting through, but 5 points on that pass. Susie Hotrod still up in the middle of the pack, moving a little bit slower. She's got two to pass. Gotham pulls back, just going to try and let her do it. She's not going to get 20 feet as the pack starts to get ever closer. She's able to get around. Nope, she does. She gets around Psychobabble. Does not get around to the pickup points. That is going to be 0-0 for that final pass. So Gotham is at 213, only 130, only picking up 5 on that last transaction.
Yeah, deranged with a good jam there, able to get a natural grand slam as Susie Hotrod was just unable to clear the pack. So 213 to 130, 2 minutes, 5 seconds left in the season. Oli has extended their box minutes. Now 43 minutes spent in the box, only 29 for Gotham. Clearly one of the stories of this game.
Oh, unquestioningly, 153 left, potentially our last jam. And our last jammers might be number 66 on the slide for Oli. And Bonnie Thunders, who's now pushing along that outside wall. The pack is behind. They've got to let her go. It is Bonnie Thunders, lead jammer.
It is Bonnie Thunders, lead jammer. It is on the slide. Jammer in the box for Oli. I believe it was a track cut major on the slide. Gives Bonnie Thunders the lead jam. And that is the fat lady singing right there, Bam Bam.
Do you just play smart and burn clock? I mean, Bonnie Thunder, she has only gone to the penalty box, I believe, 3 times, only once as jammer this game, and I think all weekend. So
Does Bonnie Thunders do that? No, she doesn't. I completely agree that it would be a safe play here, but I'm willing to bet Bonnie Thunders is going to push this just a little bit. Now, the period clock is at 102. The jam clock is at 108. So, as you said, Bam Bam, Gotham does not have to let there be another jam. They can end the game right now.
Especially considering Oli has 1 timeout remaining. No reason to prolong it if you're Gotham. They might have their motivations, but Bonnie Fenders comes around. You look to the bench. They're just like, smiles. Keep going, Bonnie.
Bonnie Thunders continues to add that total. 168 points scored in this game by Bonnie Thunders. Bam Bam, you talked about her trips to the box as she gets another grand slam there. On the Sly is out.
Comes in
with a major back block on the Sly. On the Sly goes back to the penalty box.
So I believe that
3 is 3 seconds of track time.
OMG WTF goes down hard, hits the face. Bonnie is, again, 75% of Gotham's points so far.
Bonnie Thunders does finally ease it up. A little lap skate as the clock ticks down. That's the game clock.
Everybody's on their feet.
That's the jam call off.
That, my friend, is the end of the game. And 2 in a row, I believe, for the first time ever. Back-to-back victories for any team in the WFTDA. And they have been brought to you by Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
Let's just take just a minute, let you listen to the sounds of the crowd as they rush the track. Gotham, for the third time in the brief history of the WFTDA, will take home the Hydra.
Ecstatic bench players, everybody quickly on their feet surrounding the track. Again, they have learned from past mistakes. The crowd knows, don't rush in, make sure it's all settled. I think we have a 103-point decisive victory, but either way, you just want to play smart if you're here in our audience. So, again, congratulations to Gotham. They have cinched the second. We're going to see, as they have said, the slate is now clean. Everybody starts over, but you have to realize there's going to be some changes coming up for our next season. We are no longer a divided world, north, south, east, west. We are going to divisions. We're going to have the top 40 teams going into division.
We are, Bam Bam. And, you know, I'm going to talk a little bit about this game. After 17 jams in the second half, the score stood 147 to 125. Ollie's still very much in the game. Still very much in the game.
Yes.
That was the jam where Deranged went to the penalty box after the illegal, after she made a low block, and we had the confusion with the star pass. Mm-hmm. That was the first of two power jams where Gotham absolutely opened it up. Went from 147 to 125 to 176 to 125. Olympia State stuck on 125 for the last eight jams of the game, so they're finally able to get 5 points, but it was not enough. You have to tip your hats here to Gotham. They are the third champions, three-time champions of the WFTDA,
yes,
the Gotham Girls Roller Derby.
All right, we are going to take it to ads, and we'll be right back.